Radha Krishna Pranamo, Radha Krishna Pranamo, Yuga Lakisho. Radha Krishna Pranamo, Yugala Kisho, Jivane Marane Dati.
Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram. this point in the ceremony, before the bride and her party has made their appearance, written into the ancient tradition and passed down to many generations, during this intro, there's one last opportunity, Keisha, for you to head for the Himalayas. So we're now giving you this opportunity. However, it means if you leave, you have to take sannyas.
No way.
There is some bamboo growing not too far from here. But I do warn you that there are devotees stationed at all the exits. And they look pretty big. So now's your chance if you'd like to make the go.
Hey.
He's thinking about it. Okay, he stayed. Let's give him a hand. A wise choice. And now we'll have kirtan and wait for the biggest event of the day, which is the appearance of the bride. Thank you very much.
Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaurava
Hare Krishna,
And this is the tying together of the two hands and the giving away of the bride and the acceptance by the family of the bridegroom. Nicola will be tying a garland around their two right hands.
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Charity and Keshava's mother, accepting charity below. And I'm going to read some vows, and please repeat after me. After which, we'll be pouring water on the hands, which is a sign of purification, and also, as we know from the story of Bali Maharaj, it's an important way of signing contracts. So when water is poured, the contract is Shrimad Keshav. Do you accept Shrimad Kantara as your wife and promise to protect her in her material and spiritual life and to remain faithful always? Shrimad Kantara, do you accept as your suitable husband Shrimad Keshava, and do you promise to assist him in his material and spiritual life and to be faithful always? Condition we are now, whether we're pure or impure,
When we remember the lotus eye as the personality of Godhead, we become purified inwardly and outwardly. Om. Sing the mantra, Om Keshavaya Maha. Om Narayanaya Maha. Om Narayanaya Maha.
Om Narayanaya
Maha. Brahma is the originator of our sampradaya, and this hymn was favored by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who discovered it in the Adi Keshava temple in South India, had it hand copied and delivered to his favorite disciples. It was a favorite of our founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada, who liked it, recited it at various auspicious occasions.
Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Arani Rahe Govinda Sarva Parana Karanam Chintamani Prakarasana Sukalpa Vriksha Raksha Vriteshu Sudavigra Vipadayantam Lakshmi Sahasra Shata Sambrama Sevyamanam Govinda Mani Purusham Venum vanantam aravindalaya taksham Vahavatam samasitam durasundarangam Kandarpa kotikamaniya vishesha shobham Govindamani purusham Hamaham vajam Alola chandra kala sarva namalya vanshi Ratnam gatam pranaya kedikana vilasham Shyamam Vibhangalalitam Niyala Prakasham Govindamani Purusham Kamaham Vajani Advaitam Achutam Anadim Anantarupam Adhyam Purana Purusham Navayovanamsha Redeshu Jurlava Madhurlava Mahavata Govindamani Purusham
Srila Prabhupada Ki. It's nice to see all the smiling faces, and why shouldn't we be smiling? I didn't prepare anything in my mind for this. I'm just going to speak from the heart, and I just think the starting point of what I want to say is with Srila Prabhupada, our beloved Guru Maharaj, and kind of overwhelmed at this moment because it's because of him, we are all together as one big happy family and engaged in these kind of celebrations, programs such as this, the Sangskaras, and you know, we've all come together, many of us here coming from so many different backgrounds. And it is not possible to get everybody under the same umbrella unless if you have a real big Maya program that caters to all the senses. But here we're doing something quite different. We're doing something which is heavily tantalizing to the senses. And yet there's some strictures there, there's some principles that are very contrary to the way of Kali Yuga. And I don't need to paint a picture of what is Kali Yuga. We see it all the time, every day, staring right into our faces. But what we have here is something so wonderful and so special here. A building, a very special building, approved and blessed by Srila Prabhupada. We have the presence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the male and female aspects of himself. We have the Lord in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the most merciful incarnation of the Lord. We have everybody's favorite, especially in summertime, Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra. You know, I'm talking about the Radha Yatras. And we have prasadam, we have scripture, we have each other, and a beautiful environment and atmosphere. I have to say something for the party decorators. Okay, let's hear something for them. Yeah, the astounding head priest here today and priestess conducting the program. Thank you very much for coming all the way over from the other end of the world. And I just see something very promising that the world has. We have such a nice, you know, kind of like a role model couple who have proven themselves over the last few years to blend in so nicely into the community and done such valuable service and put Krishna in the forefront of everything. Been such a nice example. And somehow or other, I feel very blessed and humbled being in this scenario here where we have a great community that's dedicated to the service of Sri Radha Kircha Gopinath. And I guess I'm just really humbled by everything here. And just wanted to say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. And this is the real marriage that you're going through, the dating ceremony. And the legal one has already been there. It's in the past behind us. But when I say real, it's the one where Krishna's in the center. So Prabhupada in the center, Krishna in the center, you're sure to have a successful, you know, life together. And marriages and families cannot stay together unless the community's right behind them. It's not a solo program, or it's not even two people together, it's a whole bunch of people together. It's a whole community together. And it's a mercy that's trickling down from the time of, well, Krishna himself and from Brahma down to this time period. It's all the mercy that's showering down, not just in the form of flowers, which we see an abundance of today, but in the form of mercy. So this is a very merciful ceremony, celebration, and so I'm happy to be part of it. And everyone else shine their merciful glance on it's such a divine couple here today. So thank you very much. We have devotees here, our young devotees, we have an aspiration to have our younger generation take more responsibility in our community here. And I believe that's a major formula that will, you know, help our society very much. And the mix of the you know, the old, the rich and old blood, plus the new rejuvenated youthful ideas come forth. That's another marriage in itself. So I think our couple here has exemplified that too, their ability to work with all kinds of devotees, all kinds of people from different backgrounds and age groups. I think that's wonderful. That's the formula that's going to work. And that's the society that Srila Prabhupada established for us. An international society for Krishna consciousness. Many different kinds of people, people of different backgrounds, people of different age groups, and different thoughts and ideas. And just applying the philosophy of Achinchabeda Vedatattva makes things really nice, like this party. Hare Krishna, the celebration. Srila Prabhupada ki.
Shaiva Pavanani Manishina. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace is Seva Bhakti Swami Srila Prabhupada ki. Translation. Acts of sacrifice, charity, and penance are not to be given up. They must be performed. Indeed, sacrifice, charity, and penance purify even the great souls. Purport. The yogis should perform acts for the advancement of human society. There are many purificatory processes for advancing a human being to spiritual life. A marriage ceremony, for example, is considered to be one of these sacrifices. It is called Vivahat Yajna. Should a sannyasi who is in the renounced order of life and who has given up his family relations encourage the marriage ceremony? The Lord says here that any sacrifice which is meant for human welfare should never be given up. Vivaha Yajna, the marriage ceremony, is meant to regulate the human mind so that it may become peaceful for spiritual advancement. For most men and women, this Vivaha Yajna should be encouraged even by persons in the renounced order of life. Sannyasis should never associate with women, but that does not mean that one who is in the lower stages of life, a young man, should not accept a wife in the marriage ceremony. All these prescribed sacrifices are meant for achieving the Supreme Lord. Therefore, in the lower stages, they should not be given up. Similarly, charity is for the purification of the heart. If charity is given to suitable persons, as described previously, it leads one to advance spiritual life. And then in the purport to text number 7, which is two texts after that, Srila Prabhupada says, and similarly, a sannyasi may perform a marriage ceremony to help his disciple in the advancement of Krishna consciousness. Kimiranyasya jnanjana shalakai chakshurun militam yena tasmai shri gurave namaha shri chaitanya mano vishtam stapitam jena bhutale swayam rupa kadamaya tadati swapadantikam Vanchakalpa Prabhubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanabhyo Vaishnavabhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shiva Sani Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. In the purport, Srila Prabhupada have us understand that there are three types of life. One is animal life in human bodies, a human life in human bodies, and spiritual life in human bodies. Generally, in the world, people know something by the term of religion or religious life. And generally, religious life is based on moral, social, and ethical values. But here we find clearly Krishna consciousness is not animal life in human bodies, and neither it is religious life of moral, social, and ethical values, or human life in human bodies. Krishna consciousness is way above that. Krishna consciousness is actually spiritual life in human bodies. So here we find that we are not claiming that we are higher than others, but actually that is a fact at the same time. So due to humility we may not claim, but due to not pracha but sadachar, but by behavior and by acts of sacrifice such as the Vibhava Yajna today and the marriage ceremony, it is by its own nature and by its own activity of devotees that purity is the force, even for the Vibhava Yajna. So we bless Keshava and Tara to not be the divine couple, but be divine to take themselves to the divine couple, Shishirada Krishna, in terms of following the rules and regulations of the Grihastha Ashram, which is human life in human bodies, but actually to transition to come to spiritual life in human bodies, which is the topmost feature of existence in this world as well as in the spiritual world, which means exclusive Krishna consciousness in action, that is called a devotional service, serving the devotees, Vaishnava Seva, devotional service, chanting the holy names, Nama Ruchi, devotional service, and bringing others to devotional service by preaching. At the same time, they should not exclusively be involved in these three, but also devotional service means taking care of each other in terms of being a husband, being a wife, and later on being a mother and father. That is also devotional service. Generally, in the culture of India, Krishna consciousness is not Indian culture. Generally in the culture of India, a sannyasi leaves everything behind, like how His Grace Vaishishaka Prabhu sort of encouraged Kesha. He has a choice here, to stay or go to the Himalayas. So generally the Indian culture means that sannyas means you leave everything behind, including living in the cities, including living amongst people, and go away. Yeah. That is called impersonalist sannyas or mayavadi sannyas. But for us in Krishna consciousness and the renounced order of life, a sannyasi does not give up family life. For us, a sannyasi makes the whole world his family. And in that spirit, us as sannyasis, when we make the whole world a family, and when there's a marriage ceremony, they are simply entering into one room of the sannyasi's home, that is the whole world as a family. So we welcome you into that room of the home of the sannyasi, which is the whole world as a family. At the same time, it is quite clear in the scriptures and given by Srila Prabhupada in numerous places that the sannyasi is the father of that home, which is the whole world as his family. So a sannyasi accepts every living entity as his son or daughter, in that sense. We've accepted them as in the sannyasa ashram, including His Holiness Bhaktivinoda Swami and myself, as our sons and daughters. At the same time, it is formally being given here that they are accepting to enter into one room in the home of a sannyasi who accepts the whole world as his home and the whole world as his family. So we feel honored and also blessed by this most auspicious ceremony to be amongst you all, and even more blessed by the presence of Mother Mirapura and Vaisheshika Prabhu, who are exemplary role models, far surpassing even other role models that I may know and come into contact with. So thank you for coming, for also blessing the ceremony today, and as well as offering his own consciousness with his good wife into the fire yajna, so that your life in this lifetime will become most auspicious, and also take others in this community and in the world as good role models for them to follow. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Anantari Vaishnava ki jai, Keshava Prabhu ki jai, Sara ki jai.
And now we will perform the Vaishnava Homa and invoke the blessings of the devotees and Lord Krishna by singing their names and special prayers. And at the end of each offering, please stick in your fingers like this and offer it in the fire of the Swaha. Repeating after me, I'll say Swaha. Please say Swaha into the fire.
Om Ajnana Kirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurudham Nina Asmai Shri Gurave Namaha Swaha 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 Deep Swaha Abhul Swaha Vandeham, Sri Guru, Sri Yukta Parakamaham, Sri Guru Vaishnavamscha, Sri Rupam, Sarvajatam, Sahaganam, Raghunathamitam, Tamasajivam, Sadvetam, Sarvadutam, Parijana, Sahitam, Krishna Chaitanya Devam, Sri Radha Krishna Padam, Sahagana, Lalita, Sri Vishakham Vitamsta, Swaha,
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 Namaho.
Shaya,
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 Bhaktida.
Shri Rupa Anuga Bhaktida.
Shri Gaura Karuna Shakti.
Shri Gaura Karuna Shakti.
Vidrahaya Namostute.
Vidrahaya Namostute.
Namaste Gauravani.
Namaste Gauravani.
Shri Murtaye Dinakarine.
Shri Murtaye Dinakarine.
Rupa Anuga Virdhava.
Rupa Anuga
Virdhava. Siddhanta Dvanta Harine.
Siddhanta Dvanta Harine.
Swaha. Vipralambara Sambhode
Vipralambara Sambhode
Svaha
Madhusudana
Svaha Svaha
Svaha
Om Pratijna Tava Govinda
Name
Bhakta Pranashyati Samsmritya,
Samsmritya,
Pranam, Samdaryaham, Samdaryam Yaham, Swaha,
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 Swaha.
Now, if you make a mistake on the Parishchitta Homa, maybe you have to do another Parishchitta for the Parishchitta Homa. But we're depending on the Supreme Personality of Godhead and all kinds of rituals, especially in Kali Yuga. The Shastras say that we depend on the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra at the beginning and the end. And that we will have, without doubt. Now we have the last portion of the Fire Yoga, which is the Purnahuti. So both of you, please take a banana in your hands and stand up. And after I repeat, after I utter this mantra and you repeat, then please offer the banana into the fire. Yes, please stand. Om Purnam Ada Purnamidam Purnat Purnam Udachate Purnasya Purnamadaya And with your right hand, please offer banana into the fire. Om Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I declare this fire yoga to be a success, and now we will have circumambulation of the fire. Keshava will lead four times around as they hold hands, right hands. And then Tara will lead three times around.
Radha Krishna, Radha Krishna. Radha Krishna Pranamo, Radha Krishna Pranamo, Yuga Lakisho. Radha Krishna Pranamo. Yugala Kisho Jivane Marane Gati Anahimo Thank you. 양계 디보 찬양해라 간다 자마르들라보 카페 헤리보 무카찬
Until one comes in contact with Krishna and his spiritual master, and then one's steps take meaning. So these final steps towards perfection in life, called the seven steps, are a time when the newly married couple can express their goals in life. Why are they stepping and where are they going? And they have written these seven goals of life themselves based on Srila Prabhupada's seven purposes of ISKCON. And now, Tara, please place your right foot within the circle. Do not let your left foot pass the right. And please hold hands, right? Yes. Step into the first circle. May Sri Vishnu lead you to propagate spiritual knowledge. Please take the second step. Do not let the left foot pass the right. May Sri Vishnu lead you to propagate Krishna consciousness. Please take the third step. May Sri Vishnu lead you to the understanding of being part and parcel of the quality of Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Please take the fourth step. May Sri Vishnu lead you to take part in the Sankirtan movement. Please take the fifth step. May Sri Vishnu lead you to the holy places of transcendental pastimes of the Lord. Please take the sixth step. May Sri Vishnu lead you to a simpler and more natural way of life. Please take the seventh step. A vow and a step very dear to my heart. May Sri Vishnu lead you to distribute books, distribute books, distribute books. Please my companion for life? Yes. Fixed in these seven vows.
Fixed in these seven vows.
All those who approve of this sacred union between Keshav Tara, please note your agreement by together saying Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna!
Ladies and gentlemen, sannyasis, please welcome Mr. and Mrs. Keshav Sharma.
Hare Krishna.
I've been really missing this friend a lot, and but I received it from Yoko Mataji, and I received it so much that I didn't expect it. And I just wanted to thank her for being always there for me, for guiding me, and just supporting through everything I've gone through. And I just, it really, really means a lot that you came here. I don't know what we did, but thank you so much.
All of our friends and supporters and all this whole community just kind of rallied around you. I mean, words cannot describe again how thankful we are for the devotees here in Toronto. So thank you for all of your love. Maybe we can give a round of applause to each other or a Hare Krishna Mahamantra for each other. Om
Tejasvi Bhava.
Tejasvi Bhava.
Tejasvi Bhava. Vairindat Padalane. Vyapara Daksho Bhava. May you have the strength to crush false ego, and may you be successful in your life's work. And the last one, which is our favorite, and I'm sure Bhishma and Thara's favorite. Om Shri Krishna Bhava. Pada Pujana Datta. Sarvakaro Bhava. And this means, may you always serve Shri Krishna's lotus feet, and may you always be absorbed in the service of Shri Radha Kishore Gopinath. On behalf of everyone, welcome to the family back.